Hello friends, today I have with me a small presentation on the history of Indian satellites.
But before launching ourselves into this wonderful journey, let us have some talk about the golden memories of satellite making. It remains one of the proudest moments not only for India's space program, but as a landmark in the history of the country. 45 years ago, on 19th April 1975, the rocket thrusters fired to launch India's first indigenous satellite. It was named Aryabhatta, yet, like many initial forays beyond the Earth's atmosphere, the project stumbled and ran afoul of roadblocks, a reminder that is still relevant today about the precariousness of ambition. So, fasten your seatbelts and get ready for takeoff. Here we come to talk about how India started making satellites. The Indian satellite program began to take shape in the early 1970s. After the eventual success of the Indian-built Rohini rocket program in the 1960s, the Indian Space Research Organization shifted focus to building indigenous satellites. Vikram Sarabhai, the ISRO founder and a renowned physicist who also had a role in the development of India's nuclear industry, appointed a team of 25 engineers and researchers. Under the direction of space scientist Dr. U.R. Rao, a 100-kilogram satellite was designed. In 1971, India's then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi received a message from the country's ambassador in Moscow saying that the Soviet Academy of Sciences was ready to assist India in launching its first satellite. Negotiations followed in New Delhi and Moscow between Indian diplomats and scientists with Soviet counterparts. Until that point, the satellite had not been named. Three were proposed. First was Aryabhatta, the second was Mitra, and the third was Jawahar. Indira Gandhi was offered the choice and Aryabhatta it was. Aryabhatta was the first unmanned Earth satellite built by India, assembled at Peenya near Bangalore, but launched from the Soviet Union via Russian-made rocket in 1975. Aryabhatta weighed 360 kilograms, with instruments to explore conditions in Earth's ionosphere, measure neutrons and gamma rays from the sun, and perform investigations in X-ray astronomy. The scientific instruments had to be switched off during the fifth day in orbit because of a failure in the satellite's electrical power system. Useful information, nevertheless, was collected during the 5 days. Here are some of the images of Aryabhatta satellite. The story of Aryabhatta should continue to inspire awe and the belief that scientists and engineers can overcome setbacks. The Aryabhatta's launch was successful at a time when leading space powers had little faith in India's chances to produce an indigenous satellite. It is a reminder of the distance the Indian space program has travelled in the last 45 years. So, we are halfway our journey. Here, we talk about the progress made by India in this field, Part 2. ISRO built India's first satellite, Aryabhatta, which was launched by the Soviet Union on 19th April 1975. In 1980, ISRO launched satellite RS-1 onboard its own SLV-3, making India the sixth country to be capable of undertaking orbital launches. SLV-3 was followed by ASLV, which was subsequently succeeded by development of many medium lift launch vehicles, rocket engines, satellite systems, and networks enabling agency to launch hundreds of domestic and foreign satellites, and various deep space missions for space exploration. It has the world's largest constellation of remote sensing satellites and various deep space missions for space exploration. Now let's talk about a very famous series, the INSAT series of satellite. The Indian National Satellite System are the family of communication satellites of India. It is a series of multi-purpose geostationary satellites built and launched by ISRO to satisfy the telecommunications, broadcasting, meteorology and search and rescue needs of the country. Since the introduction of first satellite in 1983, INSAT has become the largest domestic communication system in the Asia-Pacific region. Here we have another famous series of satellite, Gagan Satellite Navigation System. The Ministry of Civil Aviation has decided to implement an indigenous satellite-based regional GPS augmentation system, also known as Space-Based Augmentation System, SBAS, as part of the satellite-based communication, navigation, surveillance, and air traffic management plan for civil aviation. The Indian SBAS system has been given acronym Gagan GPS Aided Geo-Augmented Navigation. Thus, India has made tremendous strides in the field of space research with the development of launch vehicle technology indigenously and other significant achievement. It is now a member of Space Club. It has been successful in the application of satellite technologies for the benefit of society. It is commercially exploiting its progress made in the field of space research. All of these makes me so proud of our motherland. With this, we come to the end of our journey.